is the Little Pine Barren Cemetery, established in 1826. So let's go and see what we can find about this unique spot along the highway. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Southern Shadows and Dust. We're in the little community of Little Pine Barren, off of 29 down between McDavid and Molino. We're going to look at an old cemetery today. So here we are looking at Little Pine Barren Cemetery along 29 in North Escambia County, Florida. Cemetery from the early settlement era of the county. Really unique graves here, wrought iron fencing. A lot of these gates no longer exist. People are still in. Fortunately, this one's here. This is the grave of Francis Lynch. Died April 17th, 1896. 44 years, 4 months, and 2 days. There are some really unique graves in this cemetery that you don't see in a lot of other ones. As you can imagine, it's a loud cemetery being next to such a big highway. Lewis M., son of J.W. and M.J. Norris. Old graves in this cemetery. The old road, the Wolf Trail, passed right through here. That road was an early settlement trail, Indian route. It was also used during the war between the states when the Union came out of Pensacola from Fort Barrancas, headed north on the last great offensive of the war in this area. They came right through this area. They would have seen some of these graves as they marched north on their way to Pollard, then Miles Crossing, Canoe, and then on to Battle of Blakely. There are some graves out here that are kind of show that age of time, such as this one here. It's cracked open. Samantha A., of John A. Johnson. Now see the condition of it. Now this grave here is very interesting. This is a grave of Luke Townley, and he was private. In Filial's company, North Carolina, War of 1812, died 1826, born 1874. Now, there may be other War of 1812 veterans in this part of the state, but I have very seldom seen a headstone in this area that was a veteran from that war. And that's an important war, because that was really what started the migration into this part of the country, especially Alabama. Now, Northwest Florida was a Spanish possession, of course, but the War of 1812 and the Creek Indian War, the result of that was a great migration of people into this part of the country. Other headstones here. Mahalia Shepherd, born 1811. Edmund Shepherd. This is some of these graves that were actually paid. graves with old bricks. One interesting thing to note is that one of the largest brick makers in Florida was in this area in the late 1800s. The Macmillan Brickyard was huge. It was one of the largest brickyards in this part of the country, and it supplied brick to a lot of different structures. If you go to Defuniak Springs and go downtown, some of those buildings, about maybe 8 or 12 stacks of bricks up in the wall, it'll say Macmillan Brick, Pine Barren, Florida, and that was in this area was where it came from. Mary Bowman died 1882, and a lot of these headstones are very weathered. Reuben Bowman died December 25th, 1853, age 53 years of age. Very hard to read the inscription on some of these. James Bowman. Rebecca Applegate, born September 14th, 1852, died January 3rd, 1922. Tilda Britt, 1869 to 1910, and note that her headstone says "and twins." So apparently it was a great tragedy. This lady died possibly in childbirth. Iron fencing. Beautiful how well this was put together back in the day. Campbell's. Maddie Crabtree, born February 18, 1879, died April 1st, 1911. A lot of Crabtrees in this cemetery. Here is H.F. Crabtree, born September 7th, 1839, died January 13th, 1919. Mr. Crabtree was a veteran. Back this up a little bit. Private in Company D, 2nd Regiment, Florida Infantry, Confederate States Army, September 7th, 1839 to January 13th, 1919. There's a Woodman of the World stone here. Always an interesting marker. Albert Smith, August 6, 1885 to October 23rd, 1923. Eliza Wiggins, December 20th, 1836 to March 29th, 1935. And then we have something you don't see a lot. Headstone with a photograph inlaid. Anna M. Nicholson, September 4th, 1903 until June 11th, 1927. She came to raise our hearts to heaven. She goes to call us there. Headstones here are in various states. Some are better shaped than others. More Nicholsons here. Clarissa A. Nicholson, 1851 to 1939. Then we have some more military graves. I've always found this little section over here very interesting. Here we are with James Melvin Ward, Private, Company K, 10th Florida Infantry, Confederate States Army. I'll kind of pull some of this away. 1820 to 1890. Then you get into something you don't see a lot. Elijah Ward, Florida Mounted Militia, Rose's Company 8. Regiment, Indian Wars, 1776 to 1865. So he would have been an elderly man when the Yankees come through here in March of 1865. I very much would have liked to have talked to him about that. And here is, looks like Coven or C-O-V-A-E Nichols, Company B, 1st Florida Infantry, CSA, 1830 to 1863. That's the same regiment that James, that we saw Friday at Traveler's Rest, Jordan, James Jordan, that he was in. So these, they may have actually known each other. William Ward, Private, Company Long's Company, Florida Volunteers, Indian Wars, 1825 to 1888. So some very unusual graves in this old, old cemetery that's nearly 200 years old, seated right off Highway 29. Between McDavid and Molino. Get a chance, come out and explore the cemetery and just enjoy the view. And remember to like, subscribe, and share this video, Southern Shadows and Dust. Enjoy coming out and taking these videos, and hope you enjoy them.